Thank you for watching my new video blog. Today I'm in Zurich in Switzerland and I want to talk about the healing powers of psychedelical music. At the moment that I'm shooting this video, I just finished a very busy time. It is around Christmas and for me this means that, and I think for everyone can relate to this, it means a very hectic but also a very nice time. But especially on the hectic parts, it is for a lot of people a time where they get a lot of stress and they forget that it's a nice time. You have a lot of appointments to make, you have to go to visit family, and you have to do a lot of things for work. You have maybe appointments with work, maybe parties for work. You have to see your friends. You have maybe to search for presents for children or relatives or family, etc. Also, you have to do a lot of things for your work extra. The end of the year is coming, so it means that there's things are changing and you have to do them before the end of the year. For example, in my case, I had sort of stress about the flight miles that I have, and because I could upgrade if I just made a few more flights, and it was constantly in my mind. I was thinking, how can I make these few flights, and is it worth the money, etc. So I noticed that I had a very busy time and that it was a little bit stressed, so to say, and I noticed it in my behavior, in my body, and in my overall feeling of being healthy. You can sort of say that your brain is under stress. You have many things in your mind and you want to complete them, and it's affecting your thinking and your brain, because for example I was constantly thinking about these things I had to do, about what do I buy for Christmas, can I make the few appointments for the end of the year, will I finish them in time. And yeah, for me this was, I noticed that I had a lot more stress than as usual. And the thing is that when you put your brain under stress, it will affect your body directly. You can feel that when there's something in your mind, your blood pressure starts to rise, you feel your temperature rising, and it's not a good feeling. You feel that there's something clearly not right. And stress is bad, stress can kill you. I made a video blog about that in Paris, and it's not healthy, so you have to do something about it. And in a stress period, I noticed that my breath was short and that I had sort of anxiety attacks a little bit. I felt fear. I didn't know exactly what kind of fear where it came from, but I felt some strange fears. I noticed that it was not there was no rational thinking behind it, because the fears were strange. I had a short breath and I started thinking, oh, maybe I'm dying at this moment. Well, I know this is of course nonsense. And I noticed that it was caused by a general feeling of being unresty. I didn't took enough rest in this period, because yeah, you don't have time in this period. You are constantly busy doing things. You have to visit all these people, you have to do all these nice things. Again, very nice. I don't say that nice things cannot cause stress, and these nice things were causing me stress. So you can choose to say, okay, I stop doing these nice things because then I don't have stress, or you can do something else, and that is to use something that will make your brain calm again. And I noticed that when I was under stress, it was an attack on my body. My brain was under pressure and therefore my body was under pressure. Sort of fight mechanism. I had to fight the stress situation. So it works like that. When you put pressure on your brain, your body will get under pressure as well. And it works also the opposite way. When you start to relax your brain, your body starts to feel relaxed as well. For example, when you drink alcohol, the first thing that it does is it will relax your brain. The alcohol will cause your brain to be, the sort of part will slow down or will be overwhelmed. And the fact is that your body starts to feel relaxed as well. So this was for me like a revelation to see that when you put pressure on your brain, your body reacts. And when you, I first thought that it was all your body. So when you are under stress, you have to focus on your body to breathe, start breathing slowly, or start try to relax, or force to think about nice things, or force your brain to stop thinking. And thus, it's all a lot of work. It's again a lot of pressure on your brain. Because if you force your body to slow down, you say, okay, I have to breathe slow, I have to relax, I have to do this, this. The fact is that you are still making your brain work. You still make your brain work hard, but now to fight your stress. So that's not very effective. You can better start by slowing your brain down. And the best thing is to do it healthy, in a healthy way. And so when you start to slow your brain down, it will cause your whole body to relax. What it also does is when you start to slow your brain down, your anxiety attacks or your fears or any other things that's in your mind, your a lot of worries that you have or discontent about your life in general or whatever, you can slow them down. It's as easy as that. You are in control of your brain, and with a little bit of help you can slow your brain down and you can make yourself healthy. Because I explain it again, in the, like I say in another video blog that I made in Paris, stress is very unhealthy and will damage your body, and not only your body, but can also damage your brain. Many people get depressed or get a burnout or suffer from anxiety attacks because they are constantly under stress. And this is on a high level. When you start to constantly have this stress, then your brain and your body reacts to it. So today I want to look to this music that I sort of discovered that helped me to once in a while I listen to it to calm me down and to sort of erase the bad brain waves from my brain. Because when your brain is under stress, there's when you're thinking about negative things, or not even negative things, like I say, when you have a holiday, you're under, think about happy things. You're going to meet your family, and you're going to do meet your be with your family, and you're going to eat nice things. But when your thoughts are, when there's so much to do, when you have a very busy time, your brain can be overloaded and you have too much things in your mind. And it's time to take a step back and slow down. One way to cool your brain down, and this is what I discovered, is to listen to psychedelical music. And I want to make clear that I don't mean the psychedelical music from the psychedelical movement from the 1960s, but I mean it more in a kind of way, the music that makes you feel in a trance state. And the kind of music that I mean, and I already made some tracks myself of this kind of music, is music without any rhythm. There's no specific rhythm. Another character trait from this music is that it doesn't have any special notes. There are no real notes in it. You cannot say, well, this is in C, or these notes are into this kind of music. Another character trait of this music is that there's no real moods. So it means that you cannot really say if it's a sad song or a happy song or energetic, or it's just there, it's very abstract. Next thing is, and last thing is that it goes on continuously. There's no, it's almost like you can say it's like an ocean that is continuous, the waves are continuously going on. There's no stop in it. So it's timeless. There's no real time in the track. It doesn't really matter if you go into the intro or to the ending of the song. It all will sound sort of the same. Very abstract, because there's there's slight small differences, but they're really minor. And it is different from other relaxing music, because in traditional relaxing music you hear recognizable sounds, for example water drops or a waterfall, or you will hear a seashore or birds, and with some flutes or whatever, and they play some kind of relaxing music. And it's not like this, it's totally abstract. I made two tracks myself, and I must say I made one by accident. I was interested in the psychedelical parts of, for example, bands as My Bloody Valentine, and I really like these parts where the music is not really, where the music is abstract, where you can go, where it's more wave patterns than that it's really like a pop song. And the first song that I made, and I will put it down here in my under the video, I started as a pop song, and then I reversed the last parts, and I started to build up to this abstract part. I started to break down certain patterns that are used in music so that it will become more abstract, and that you will become in a different state, in the trance state that you are looking for when you want to relax. And since there is no real mood, you can listen to it without any judgment. Like I say, it doesn't remind you about anything. It's just the music that I make, the song that I make, was just my guitar playing, delays, effects. I play my guitar, and there were just so many effects over it, delays and reverbs and reverses, that it sounded like abstract sounds, like a wave of sound, a big wave of sound where you can almost dwell into. And because there's no mood, because there's nothing to hold on to for your brain, it makes your brain feel relaxed because it's abstract. So it means that you cannot focus on anything. There's no mood, there's no rhythm, there's no stop, there's no break, there's no change, there's no tones, there's only the music itself. And this will help you to relax. This is what your brain causes to focus, and your brain waves will change from very strong, very, from a lot of brain waves per minute towards fewer brain waves per minute. I told you that I accidentally discovered the effects of the psychedelical music. I told you I made this song, and it was an idea to just play with wave patterns, with sound patterns, and just to make my song more interesting. That's to look if that you can go from a pop song, which you notice it's like pop melody, into a more music where the rules are not so strict. You can hear that there's a reverse part, and that from there on you will start to hear strange noises, which is just me playing a lot of delays on my guitar, and it's very abstract and you cannot really focus on it. It's so abstract, it slows your brain down, your brain waves down. I noticed that when I listened to this music in my bed at night, that I fell asleep every time that I listened to it. Around 7 minutes I started to feel tired, and I fell asleep. So to me this was a good sign that this music worked to help me fall asleep. And I tried it more times, I put it on repeat as well. And when I couldn't sleep, I turned on the music. And what happens with this psychedelical music is that your brainwave starts to change. When you have a lot of stress, when you think a lot, your brainwaves are very spiky, and there are many brainwaves in 1 minute. So this means that you are in a panic mode, and this means that your brain is very active, overly active, on a high voltage, you can so to say, and you need to slow down to feel good again, because the high spiked waves are causing your body to a damage, and it's not healthy, and you want to fall asleep, you want to take your feel relaxed and feel at peace. So I noticed that this music gives you automatically and instantly this effect of relaxation. And you don't have to do any weird mantras, you don't have to tell yourself that you're in a good place, that you feel fine, that you don't have to worry, you don't have to talk to yourself, which you see a lot with yoga or meditation. you don't have to focus on anything as well. You don't have to focus on your body. You don't have to focus on your breathing or on your position or on your whatever. You know, all these things that you have to do with meditation, because it doesn't work, because you still have to do something. It means that you're not slowing down your brain waves quick enough. And this is what you want. It's not about... you want to have the best solution, the quickest solution, and the most effective solution. And by listening to this psychedelical music, you don't need to do it in a special place. You don't need to sit down or to lay down. You can do it while laying down or sitting down, but you can also do it while walking around. You can put it on your telephone, and you can listen to it. You can put it on repeat. You can listen to it as long until you fall asleep. So you can download the tracks. I put them under my YouTube video. You can find two links to the songs, and you can download them with an MP3 converter and use them to put them on your phone and listen to it when you are when you cannot sleep in the night. You can try many things. I tried a lot of things, but every time the best thing for me is when I cannot sleep is listen to these tracks. And I'm sure to make more of these tracks in the future, so keep watching my channel and you maybe will find a new psychedelical song so that you can have sort of combination or a set of songs that will help you fall asleep. And not only to fall asleep, it can also help you to heal yourself, because the video blog is about healing yourself. For example, when I had this very stressed out period, I listened to this song, to this music, and I felt calmed down. I felt relaxed. And I played it twice, I think, and it helped me. And after two times, I felt more calmed down and more relaxed, because this is the great thing. It doesn't cost you anything. You just have to put it on. You can still think about your things. You don't have to force yourself to not think about your problems. Just think about your problems. Do whatever you do normally, but keep the song on, because the song will automatically change your brainwave patterns. It will influence your brainwave patterns, and this means that you don't have to do anything. It will happen. It is like taking a pill, a relaxation pill, or taking drugs or alcohol, but then in a healthy way. It's not unhealthy to do, because it doesn't harm you, and it's not addictive. Well, not for me, because I mostly have to force myself to listen to this track when I'm stressed out. Most of the times I try to do other things, but the final thing that helps is this RD's psychedelical songs. And by doing so, by listening to the psychedelical tracks, you can prevent yourself, you can heal yourself from a lot of stress. And this is very good news, because stress is very dangerous. It's lethal, it can kill you. Like I explained in another video blog that I made in Paris. And it's very good to listen to it. So feel free to download it and let me know if it works. You can write a message and let me know if this really helped you to calm down and to heal your stress, to remove your stress from your life. I will be glad to hear from you what you think about it. So that was it for today from Zurich, Switzerland. I say thank you for watching and see you next time.